Problem 6.2-2. The bar is subjected to a uniform bending moment of 20 newton meters. Determine the maximum stress resulting from stress concentrations. Here's the bar. A moment is being applied, and the dimensions are given, and we see that there is a change in cross-section abruptly halfway along. To solve this problem, we're going to be using this chart taken from Hibbler's Mechanics of Materials, 9th edition. To use this chart, we need to get a couple of ratios. First, we need the ratio W over H. We can get that from this figure here and the geometry in the problem. And we also need this ratio R over H. As shown in this figure, W is the larger height dimension, which is 25 millimeters in our case. H is the smaller height dimension, which is 15 millimeters in our case. So the ratio W over H is equal to 1.67. The ratio R over H, R is the fillet radius, which is 5 millimeters, and H is the smaller height dimension, which is 15, and that ratio gives us 0.33. Now, to use this chart, we will first come in with our W over H ratio of 1.67 to identify a line that we'll use to get our K value. And here is a 1.5 value, and the next one up is 3. So we're going to be closer to this this line, which is the 1.5 line. Next, we'll take our ratio of R over H, which is 0.33, which is right about here, and we'll draw a vertical line up until we cross the our 1.67 line. We'll have to do a little interpolation there. Okay, using the chart, I was able to approximate a location where our ratio of R over H, 0.33, would intersect a line of that represents the WH ratio of 1.67. Then I draw a horizontal line over to the K scale on the left, and I interpolate a value for K, and I get a K value of approximately 1.32. The next step to find the maximum stress, considering stress concentrations, is to use this equation here. In this equation, we take K as a multiplier and multiply it against the value for maximum stress in the beam resulting from bending. And to find values for I and C, we're going to use the most severe section, which is going to be the smaller cross section. To get our moment of inertia, we need to recognize what the cross section here looks like here on the smaller height piece. And I've taken a section at AA prime, and I've drawn the cross section there. And we see that the height is 15 millimeters. The thickness is 4 millimeters. That's given here. T is equal to 4 millimeters. And because this is a rectangle, we can use the equation BH cubed over 12 to find the moment of inertia for that cross section. So for moment of inertia, we get a value as shown, and the C value that we'll be using in this equation here is the distance from the neutral axis to the furthest away point on that cross section, and we can go either up or down. Either way, it's the same. It's half of 15 millimeters, or 0.0075 meters. Now, plugging in values for our moment, 20 newton meters, C and I and K into the expression for maximum stress, we get a value of 176 megapascals. And we're done.